Previously on Subnautica. Morning video, the prawn suit got stuck in a rock, and I was stuck inside it. There was literally no way for me to get out. I tried console commands, I tried teleporting, I tried killing myself. I tried everything. I could not get out of the prawn suit, and the prawn suit would not move. So I had to revert to a previous save and lost everything that I did. And now for the next episode of Subnautica. Hey guys, hello and welcome to CJ Games. It's Chris here with some Subnautica. Alright, so, oh, as you can see, yep, this is what we got from our hatched egg. Let's go in and have a look at it. Look at it, it's adorable, it's a cuttlefish. We have a pet cuttlefish now. Isn't that adorable? It hatched from our egg. It hatched whilst I was actually doing a lot of work. There's a lot of work I've done off camera on getting the hab back to where it was before the whole game crash issues that we were having. As you can see, I've added a whole new section over there, which I'll go and show you what's going on in that area in a minute. I've added some stuff over there. I don't know. Do you guys remember the nuclear reactor? I can't remember. It's been so long. I think the nuclear reactor, you guys remember me building the nuclear reactor. So anyway, there's a nuclear reactor over there, if I'm so sorry. I built this little farm here, and I've stocked up on all these gel sacks. So now we actually have no problem getting gel sacks at all. I'm not sure what to use these other beds for yet. I've been trying to find a place to build table coral, but for the life of me, I can't figure out how to do it.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I'm not entirely sure you can. So I've bulkheaded this place up a little bit more. There's a few more bulkheads kicking around. There's one in here. There's one over there that leads to the nuclear reactor. They're still not opening properly. I'm not sure what's going on there. It's nuclear. Unfortunately, I don't have any fuel for the reactor, so I can't really use it yet. But that's all I've really done this way. I've got the modification station. My prawn suit is over there. I have renamed and color-coded a lot of our stuff, our vehicles. So here we have the Ares 1, named after the god of war. They're all named after Greek Roman gods. I think they're Greek. So here's my prawn suit, and my prawn suit now has a drill arm. Yeah, we got a drill arm in the prawn suit. Alright, so let's jump out of here. Here's the vehicle station. Modification station that we built. It's pretty nice. So that's red because it's red for war. Our Cyclops is kicking around out there somewhere. Where is my Cyclops? Oh, it must be up there. That's where the Mercury is. The Mercury, you know, for speed. That's our Seamoth. Yep, there it is. There's a Cyclops. It's now nice and blue and white. It's pretty nice. Got a a zone in here. I moved everything forwards one, so I could put these behind it in our little hydroponics bay. Now we're growing nice plants underwater. So let's go and see what's in this new wing over here. You can see I've minimalized out the bedroom a little bit because I moved some of the stuff. There's our nice little cuttlefish. Look at him. He's adorable. If we come through here, we get to the research department. Look at this. Look at the work I put into this. This is pretty good. It's good, doesn't it? Little aquarium, which we can put some fish in. We'll go get some fish about later. Nuclear waste bin, which you can use as a trash can. It's quite nice. An actual trash can. Some shelves and stuff. I need more stuff to put on the shelves, but I'm not entirely sure what's in the game. I should make that Markiplier doll at some point. Put that up. Alright, and as you can see in here, we've got specimen tanks. We got lots of specimen tanks. That's right. It's a little research section for what's going on under the sea. These are not blowfish, what are they called? Bombfish? Charge fish, something like that. They're I bred two of them originally, and they're actually breeding themselves. So yeah, there's an egg right there. They're actually breeding themselves in these chambers, so that's pretty cool. They breed themselves. So those are breeding. Over here we have the ray. It's a little skate ray, I think it's called. Skate fish, something like that. It was the only one I could find for the egg, so we only have one of those. And in here, yeah, that's right, we've got some sharks. Yeah, some stalkers. They're pretty nifty. And they've laid an egg for another stalker, so that's good. We'll have to get more. We'll have to work on having more, you know, more zones for our fish. Let's secure this, though. Let's secure the lab for now, just in case anything, you know, breaks out. So that's what I did. off camera. You can see my power's up to 300 out of 2,800 now because of that nuclear reactor. There's no power for the nuclear reactor because I don't have any uranite. So, what do we have left to do? So far, we have a life pod signal we need to go and investigate around here somewhere, I think. Did we ever go see life pod 12? No, we didn't. Life pod 2, sorry. Life pod 2 is over there. Let's go check out life pod 2. We'll take our... You know what, let's get our Mercury out of the Cyclops.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
We'll put the prawn suit in it. How's the Cyclops doing in terms of power? We're at 27% power, so we should have enough for now. Let's leave that. So we should have enough for now in terms of power. Let's turn the light... I can't turn the lights off, alright. Let's get rid of the Seamoth. As you can see, our Seamoth is now a nice yellow and blue colour, so I can see it more easily.
All systems online.
So let's head down here. We'll take out the prawn suit and dock the prawn suit into our... Oh, this is a bit damaged, isn't it? Let's repair our Seamoth. Ah! No, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to repair it. Alright, here we go. Repair the Seamoth. Come on, Mr. Seamoth. Alright, there we go. Seamoth's repaired. Let's hop into our prawn suit here. Yup. And here we are. Hopping on in.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Yup. We've got a nice drill arm now, so we can, like, drill, 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 drill. It's pretty good. I can't remember if I used it or not. Did I use it? I guess not. I guess I've never used it yet. But it's for those large, you know, sections of stuff. So let's store our Seamoth in here. Mercury is docked. Alright, probably should have named it Mercury 1. Oh, and the Cyclops is called the Zeus. That's what it's called. The Zeus. Oh, here's the prompt suit. Alright. Come on, get in. There we are. Alright, so let's position the prawn suit underneath the Cyclops. And here we go! Hooked in. Good. Let's close our lid there. Alright. Let's go check out life pod 2, I think. We're good on food and water. So let's turn our engines on.
Engine powering up.
What speed are we on at the moment? We're at mid speed, that's good. Alright, let's head on over to life pod 2. So a fair ways away. But we'll get there. Let's rise up. I don't think it's in the direction of the Aurora, so I don't think we're going to have to go around the Aurora. Oh, Aurora's over there. So, we'll head on down. I think C is down. Yep, C is down. Alright. We'll enjoy ourselves while we're looking around. We've got the lights. I'm pretty sure we can... There's a way to turn the lights on. Ah, there we go, yeah. I can use right click to turn the Cyclops lights on. Or off, yeah. There we go. Oh! I forget how big this thing is. I just took it over the shallows. Whoa! Alright, so, hang on, I didn't bring anything important with me, did I? No, just some titanium. That's nothing important. Something bounced off me. Alright, here we go. Heading on down into the depths. Where's this? Oh, it's the forest. That, like, mushroom forest. In fact, I think that's exactly what it is called, the mushroom forest. Let's head down. I don't really want to... Ooh, I'm going to bounce off that. I don't really want to ding off too much. Let's use our cameras to look around. This is the keel camera, so it's underneath the ship. Kind of just looking as I'm going. Alright, some sharks down there. That's nothing too interesting. Check out life pod 2. Yeah, it's like it. I had a comment on one of the first videos. And... Oh, I've forgotten your name. I'm terribly sorry. began with a T. I'm terribly sorry. It's been a while since I've looked at that comment and replied to it, and something about like how good the story on this game is, and it is like all the stuff I'm finding out about, you know, just looking through the PDAs and stuff like that, it looks really, really interesting. So it should be very nice and fun to play. And so far, you know, we found out that the Aurora, the ship we were on, was sent here. There was some nice... Oh, let's go down here. Yeah, the Aurora that we were sent on here was sent to pick up survivors for another ship, the Degassi. There was three survivors, whose names I've also forgotten, and they all died. Horrible Leviathan attack. Wow, this thing sank, didn't it? Alright, so I'm gonna keep heading down here. Oh, it's deep. Let's turn the... Creature attack? What's attacking me? Well, what attacked me? Oh! There's a bunch of electro eels down there. That can't be fun. Alright. Well, let's keep going this way. I mean, those lights don't really seem to be doing much, do they? So let's turn them off and conserve some... Yeah, there's electro eels everywhere out there. What's the health doing? Health's doing alright. We're doing alright with health on the Cyclops. I think another one. Yeah, there's another electro eel. Man, it's beautiful down here. Look at it. Let's descend into the darkness. Whoa. I think this is what's known as the Blood Kelp Zone. I think that's what this area is called. What kind of depth am I at? Oh, yeah, I'm about getting there with the depth. Oh, listen to that beat! That's nice. Alright, so I think I'm going to have to take my prawn suit out for a swim here. So let's do exactly that. Let's go get our prawn suit. Alright, here we go. Prawn suit away! Alright, here we go. This place is amazing. So that was blood oil. Here we are, lifeblood 2. I'm trying to find. Oh, there's the hole now. We have to get out to do that. But what? This is drill gold. Well, it's gold. We can drill the gold, which is great because you drill it. There we go. It's popping off gold for us. The vehicle automatically picks this one up because you're drilling it. Let's get some nice gold out of this. You can always do with more gold. I don't think there's like an energy to this, like, you know, with like the laser cutter, you have to power it. I don't think there's any power to it, so we'll just keep drilling away. Hopefully we won't get attacked by electro mules. This all goes into the vehicle storage, as you can see. Which is the storage pack you saw me check earlier on the back of my prawn. Oh, there's a lot of gold in this. Alright. Awesome. Alright, let's check out Lifeblood 2. Let's see what's going on over here. Alright, Lifeblood 2, here we go. PDA, let's just listen to it.
Flotation devices failed.
We're flooding. Evacuate.
Wait. I can reconfigure the O2 system to act as a bilge pump.
It's working.
Okay, good news. We're alive and we've stopped sinking.
Bad?
The oxygen's going to run out in 30 minutes and we're 500 meters down.
What do we do?
We'll have to use the remaining juice to send a distress call and build whatever gear we can. Then we find a way to the surface.
Alright. So that was like a good little idea, but it kind of backfired on them, didn't it? Looks like they're dead. Great. I'm starting to think there's no survivors but me. I saw a warper over there. That's what those like teleporter things are called. They're called warpers. Let's pick up some more quartz here. I'm kind of having a gander around while I'm down here. The Cyclops is right above me, so I should not have painted that thing blue, should I? That was a dumb idea. This is called deep. What the hell was that? This is called deep shrooms. Say deep shrooms. Oh, what's this? Is that a creature egg? No, it's uranite. Uraninite, even. Yes, awesome. Ah, there's more uraninite. I can swear I can hear something attacking me. What am I stuck on? Stuck on a gel set. Come on. Alright. Yeah, now we can make some rods for our nuclear reactor. Come here. Gimme. There we go. Warpers over there still. Warping around. He's warping around. Ooh! Well, this looks fun. What? We should take a journey down there. Whoops. Well, maybe we shouldn't take a journey down there. Now I'm thinking about it. We have a uraninite. You know what? I've got an idea. I really should not have painted that damn thing freaking blue. It was just like painting it black, wasn't it? Alright, let's go put our... Shut up, biter. Let's go put our uraninite and stuff inside the Cyclops. Because that way, we can... Let me just line this up. I think that should be about right. Yep, there we go. That way, if we die horribly and lose the prawn suit, we're not going to lose all this. We can just swim back down here and get the Cyclops. Crap, I didn't think this through. Right, I'm gonna deploy the prawn again. Let's have a quick look around, make sure there's nothing about to come munch our faces off. Alright, out the prawn suit we get. And let's take all the stuff out of the prawn. Okay, there's something swimming up behind me. Now let's very quickly get back in the prawn and fly right back up again. Open, please. Thank you. Alright, now let's put our goodies inside the Cyclops. So we have a bunch of lockers down here. Let's put it in here. Fill this up. Okay, and we've got another locker to fill up. Because I don't think anything's really going to attack the Cyclops without me in it. No, I don't just want to disembark the Cyclops, I want to get in the prawn. Let's turn the lights off in here, save some power. Let's turn the engines off for us as well.
Engine powering down.
There we go. We're only at 24% and I still don't have a power cell charger. Alright, let's deploy! Alright, it was this way, wasn't it? There's a warper over there. That's what's making that noise. Alright, now, I'm actually going to save my game real fast, because the prawn suit has a slight tendency, and it's what caused me to mess up the game save file in the first place, to get stuck on things, especially with this the way the game generates its pop-in like that. Like, stalactites aren't classified as terrain, they're like separate entities, so they pop in right in front of you. And they're kind of annoying, and whoa, that cave lit up like a Christmas tree. Alright, yeah, let's descend. Descending down. Oh man, look at this, we're under 500 meters now. Whoa.
Medical scans show a nearby opening, leading to a biome with extensive fossilized remains.
Cool. Biome with extensive fossilized remains. Sounds cool. This is some uraninite here, I think. Yeah. I think we should drill this. Because this is like the main component of stuff we need for the, the nuclear reactor rods. So I'm also thinking about taking this and then just, like... I don't know, there doesn't seem to be anything too dangerous down here at the moment, unless there's something right behind me right now. Which it sounds like there is. I can see it flitting around. I think it's just a light at the... I don't think it's anything too interesting. Alright, there we go. I'm thinking about swimming this stuff back up to the Cyclops again. Oh, it's you. You know what? I'm gonna take it back up in the prawn suit. But I'm not actually gonna get in. Oh, there's more here. Well, this is where we come for our reactor fuel for sure. Oh man, there's loads of it down here. Look at this. We're like rich with uranium. I'm just gonna call it uranium because let's be honest, that's freaking what it is. Well, it's not. It's actually like U204 or whatever it was. Uranonite. But there's our Cyclops. It's going to get real dark in a second when this biome's light signature pings out. We're back to the crappy one. So wait for it. It's about to get real dark up in here. Wait for it. Wait for it. Unless it's like daytime out there now. Maybe it's daytime. Maybe that's what's causing it. Come on. Right, I'm gonna head up here into the Cyclops. Oh shoot, that wasn't right. No. Descend! Alright. I need to get this stuff out of the prawn. You're supposed to be red, prawn suit. Alright, let's get more of this uranonite out of here. Problem is, I've got to be careful because I don't want to charge the prawn suit too much and end up running out of juice in the Cyclops. Alright, let's put this uranonite away. Should have brought an extra power cell with me. Unless if I pull the... Maybe I can pull the power cell from the prawn suit. Yeah. Hell, prawn suit, you're supposed to be red! Alright, anyway, let's head back down to the cave. I'm not going to dig up any more uranium. I'm going to go for an explore. It said fossils. That sounds good. Come on. This thing is so easy to get stuck on stuff. I'm going to save the game again. I'm only doing, like, active saving whilst this prawn suit's going, because I don't want to lose all my save progress again. Like, it wouldn't be so bad if the prawn suit wasn't so buggy. Let's head on down. It's so cool down here. Which, of course, is code for, Chris, you're about to get a Leviathan to the face in about 4 seconds. So there's an opening that leads to a fossil biome.
Seek fluid intake.
Ah, crap. Of course I need fluid. Ugh. What's this? It's copper ore. Oh, it's the pretty things. What the holy hell is that? Buzz off. Whoa. That looks like a toxic river of some kind. Look at this place. I mean, I could build a habitat in, like, that area back there. It's like a... Get out of here. It's like a staging base. Surely. And I can run it off nuclear power. There's plenty of stuff to power nukes down here. Whoa. This biome is amazing. Oh my god, it's a ghost leviathan. It's small, though. Whoa. I'm just in awe of this place. Alright. I'm gonna head on out, because if I'm not careful, I'm going to, drown to death. Ooh, diamond. Gimme. I need to figure out what I want to put on the other arm. A ghost leviathan's not following me, is it? Well, we know there's a ghost leviathan in here. Out of the way. I feel like I'm being chased down. Some sweet chase music going on. Let's go prawn suit. Wow, this is awesome. It's so pretty down here. It's actually really difficult to grab things with these stupid prawn suit arms. Alright, let's head out and we'll head back to base. And we'll work on getting more water and stuff. I'm thinking about maybe building a small forward base down here. Because there doesn't seem to be anything in this cave particularly that's too dangerous. You know? Like, I could set a base here. And then it would be somewhere we could, like, come in and out of. We could use nuclear power to power it. Because there's plenty of materials down here. So we could use... Yeah, we could use nuclear power to power it.
Seek fluid intake immediately.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is good. This is a good idea. This is what we're going to do. We're going to build a forward base in this zone. Now, I already have the beacon for Lifeblood 2. It's just turned off at the moment. I found that out. It just turns off the beacons. It doesn't remove them. So, I can reactivate the beacon for Lifeblood 2. And we can build a forward base down here. Just like it's just a small one. Just a nuclear reactor and a few rooms. And then we'll work from there. So, let's head on up here in the Cyclops. We're going to have to build some more power cores for the Cyclops, I'm thinking. So, let's close this. Definitely have to build some more power cores for the Cyclops. Turn my lights back on. Pilot this up. Yeah, power's draining, look at it.
Engine powering up.
So, alright, we're on medium speed. Let's rise up. And spin back around so we can find where the hab is. Is that a ghost leviathan? Looked a bit like one. Where's the hab? There it is, over there. Alright, hab's over there, so let's head back towards the hab. We're at 200 meters, 20% power. We gotta get over there quick or we're not gonna do too well. I mean, wow, this is amazing. So much to explore and so much to do. I can build the escape rocket, but I'm going to take a wild guess that I need something to build it that's like really far down. Alright. Excuse me, shark. I am coming through. The good news is we got all of that uraninite. So, we are going to be able to build some rods for our nuclear reactor. The only thing I could see us having a problem getting down there is titanium. But, we could always go on a run for titanium. I mean, we could use the main base to stockpile titanium and go from there. But I definitely want to try and put a... What's that over there? Post habitat, 250 meters. Maybe I should take the sea moth and go and explore that. But yeah, definitely we're going to build a forward base there. That's definitely what we're going to work on, is building a forward base at Lifeblood 2. Man, it's so pretty down there. I mean, there's a go- Oh, crap. This can't be good. Alright, well, let's get this Cyclops as close as I can. Because I'm going to die of water. Not really much I can do about that. So, if we get it as close as we can, then we'll just swim back and get it. Come on. We're in the shallows now, so...
Oh.
Yep. I mean, the hab is, like, right there. But I am gonna die. Probably on the next tick.
Ooh.
Oh no, not dead yet. Come on, hab's right there. So I can't see my health while I'm piloting this thing. I'm gonna get like 2 feet from the base and die, aren't I? I don't want to be careful of that wreck. Oh, there's a nice reef back there. Whoa, I bounced off something. Probably the wreck. Alright. Let's keep on trucking. Alright, we made it. We made it back. And yeah, I'm dead. Whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa! Yep, here we go again. Yep. Great. Now this damn thing is stuck. How the hell am I supposed to fix this?
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
This is bad. This is really bad. Can I get this thing out? Oh, okay, good. We're good. Alright. Woo! Come on, level yourself out, Cyclops. Alright, there we go. That was close. I almost lost another frickin' thing. Alright, well the Cyclops is going to slowly level itself out, I think. It should do anyway.
Engine powering
power off its engines. Let's turn off the internal lights. Yeah, Cyclops seems to be leveling itself out, so... Let's head down the ladder. And grab the stuff out of these lockers. All of our goodies. Goodies, goodies, goodies. Look at all that gold we've got. Alright. Let's get out of this thing. Yeah, you're balanced out now. Alright, good. Okay, so... We'll head back in here. We got a bunch of goodies.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I definitely wanted to make a forward base in that little cave. Yeah, this is the filtration machine. Probably gonna need some more storage containers, aren't I? I'm about out of space, yeah. I actually should be able to make some, because we need a materials depositing station. I guess we'll just keep using the scanner room for now. I don't really know where to put it. So I wanted to turn this into, like, more water filtration. Alright, let's interior modules, locker. I put a locker on a locker? Nope, can't put a locker on a locker. Jeez, this is... Oh, I suppose we could put some in the uranium lab. That's what we're going to call it from now on, the uranium lab. Let's put one here. Nope, and let's get another one. And put him here. Alright, good. Now we can store all this stuff in here. There we go. I should like organize all my stuff, but I'll do that off camera because nobody wants to sit there and watch me organize stuff. I mean, nobody wants that. How's the water filtration coming along? Oh, we got more water. Excellent. Let's put this in our water locker. I keep dying, so it keeps doing that. We got a bunch of Chinese potatoes as well that we can eat for food. To be honest, actually, this is a lot of what I'm doing is I'm just, like, eating the Chinese potatoes. And it's generating, like, food and water. Like that. I'm actually low on health from when I respawn, so I'll have to work on that. I need to go get more stuff from the Cyclops first. Don't do that. I need to recharge the power cells in the Cyclops. There's a lot of stuff to do before we can build the forward base. So we might not get to the forward base in this episode, but we will definitely get to the forward base at some point. Right, they're all empty. The prawn suit had some stuff in it too, so I need to get into the prawn suit. Hang on a minute. I've got an idea here. If I get out of my prawn suit and I open the storage, take that out. If I pull the power cell, pull both power cells from the prawn suit, because, look, bear with me here. Trust me, it's an idea and it's going to work. Trust me. If I pull both cells from the power plant, I seem to notice that it doesn't take the same amount of energy to charge a cell on the Cyclops. Like, the Cyclops' cells drain slower than the energy charge on the prawn suit. So if I pull, say, this dead cell and put a new one in, and pull this... No, I need to pull a half full one, so that the prawn suit has enough energy to jump back up. And I can use the prawn suit to charge the Cyclops. I mean, I'm entirely sure that's the way electricity works, right? No, it doesn't. Alright, I guess I'm going to have to pull this 1% one. So, let's load it with that. And hopefully 1% is enough thrust to get us up here. If not, I'll have to pull a cell from the Mercury. This is how you do it under the sea, guys. You got to,
emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Come on. Alright, power source. 0% cell. Power source. 1% cell. Alright, enter the prawn. Alright, here we go. We got 1%. It didn't work. We didn't get very far. Alright, let's pull the power cells. Pull that cell. And pull that cell. Also, the base charges... What the hell is wrong with me? I've got a power cell charger here the whole damn time! It's the frickin' base! I could just pull the prawn suit up here. Oh my god, this was... Oh, this was a stupid... Stupid risk.
All systems online. Oh my god.
Alright, so here's what I'm gonna do, is I'm going to... I'm gonna pull the cell from the Seamoth, which is under here. Put one of the 0% cells in. I don't want to access the upgrades right now. What the hell did I just do? What did I just drop? Oh, you're in a night, okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a cell in here. Put another cell in here, and then see if this plan works with charging it using the Cyclops. So, Cyclops is at 50%. Alright, Cyclops is at 50%, and Prawn Suit's at 0%. So let's see if the Cyclops charges the Prawn Suit enough. Seamoth doesn't even have a power cell in it, so... Let's just put that dead power cell in. While that's charging, we are going to go and have a look at the nuclear fuel rod problem. So what do we need to craft a nuclear fuel rod? No, that's not the fabricator. Right, here's the fabricator. What do we need to craft a nuclear fuel rod? Okay, we need lead, titanium, glass, and uraninite crystal. Well, that seems really easy. Got some lead in here. Let's pull these two out. Let's make... I can make glass with this... Oh, no, I have two quartz right there. Let's put this diamond away. Let's put all this uraninite away apart from three. There we go. And then... We needed one titanium. Alright, let's go see if we can make a fuel rod. Let's see how nuclear fuel does this. Make some glass. And then we'll make a reactor rod. There we go! We have a nuclear reactor rod. Let's put a rod in here. Okay. It's charging up. We put four rods in there. How many rods can I make? I can make three rods. One, two, three, four, five, six. Need a couple of titanium still and a couple of leads. So what did I do with the titanium? Oh, I made things with it, didn't I? Do I need titanium in any of these lockers? Of course we don't. Because why would we? Alright, I need to go get some titanium. Alright, let's get some titanium. I mean, the base is powering up, so it definitely seems to be doing something. Alright, what's next on our list? Titanium, that's it. That's what we need to go and get. To have a look around for some titanium, I just need, like, two pieces. So, just one scan of something would be enough. Scan, or limestone chunks. Let's get that stupid map out of my way. It's annoying me in the way. There's usually a bunch of titanium just lying around out here. Like on the edges, because the sharks move it. The stalkers. Looking around. God, why is there never anyone Anita, but when there's like none around, there's loads? Alright. Anything in here I can scan? Nope. Aha! Yep, some. Alright, so I think for this episode, what we'll do is we'll see if our charging system is working. And then we will go and investigate the Pegasi habitat in our Mercury. And then once we're done with that, that'll be the end for this episode, I think. And then the next episode, we'll definitely start working on figuring out, setting up that forward base. Because I really like the idea of having that forward base there. Let's make some salt. Titanium. Let's crack this down. It's titanium. Yup. Then we need to crack this down into glass. Yup. Then we can make some reactor rods. We can make two of them. Yep. Personal equipment, just pipes and stuff. Active. Okay. Equip and equip. I mean, things should be going well. It doesn't say, like, when they expire, though, so, like, I feel like I'm not gonna know when they expire until just, poof, they're gone. But it's definitely working. It's 100% working. So now maybe we can add some more water filtration. Titanium, copper wire, and aerogel. What do we need for that? Well, copper wire is obviously just two copper. I don't have that. Oh, I do. So... copper. What was aerogel again? Aerogel was gel sack and ruby. Ahaha! Well, let's go grab ourselves a ruby. Because I know we've got a bunch of those kicking around. Yep, a ruby. Let's go get ourselves a gel sack. Because I know full well we got some gel sacks. I started making them. Ahaha! he's stuck on that thing again. Alright, let's grab ourselves a gel sack. Hang on, how many aerogel did we need? Just the one. I'm thinking maybe I can make two of these, to be honest with you. Can I maybe make two of them? I've got enough copper wire. Let's get a second one. How's our charging going of the prawn suit versus the titanium versus the Cyclops?
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
How did we do here? This is down to 34%. The prawn suit's up to 100%. So it's charged one cell. Alright, okay. New plan. What do you mean locked? Did I just get locked in my Cyclops? Alright, well, anyway, let's get back in. There's still some lights on in here, to be honest. Alright. Why is that locked? It doesn't make any sense. Why? Why are you locked? I don't understand. Hang on, why is the Cyclops on its side? Oh, it's the Wreath Leviathan. Let's get our engines back online.
Powering up.
I gotta get this thing out of the way of the Wreath Leviathan. I think that's why it's locked. Oh. Come on, I'm stuck on the Wreath Leviathan. And I think I'm stuck on the Sea Moth that was underneath me as well. Alright. Let's put the Cyclops back over where... Yeah, there we go, I just heard it release. Let's put the Cyclops back over where it was, over here. So we're, like, out of the way of Wreath Leviathans. And I think we're just gonna have to, like, keep charging the cells for now using, like, one... What is that? Oh, it's one of my cameras, that's right. I had a bunch of cameras, didn't I? Ugh. The Cyclops is too big, I'm telling you. It's just too big. Alright. This should be good. Alright. Now I should be able to release the... Yeah, release it. Alright. So here's what I'm going to do. Is I'm going to release the prawn suit, and then I'm going to pull all the power cells from the Cyclops. That's the plan here. Is pull the power cells from the Cyclops. Where are they? Okay, power cell one. And power cell. No power cell. There we go. Unload that one. That's almost all the energy. Still got one cell left in it. That one's still at 100%, so that's doing okay. Let's pull that one. For fuck's sake. I'm not doing too good at this power cell business, am I? Alright, let's turn the lights off so we're not draining any more of that other cell. Yep, there we go. Turn the lights off. Turn the engines off. I think we forgot to turn the engines off.
Engine yep. Powering down.
Okay, that's good. Now we'll head on down. Get out of the Cyclops. And we are going to take our prawn suit. We're going to pull one of the cells from it. Swap it out with a zero. Alright. We'll leave the Cyclops up there to do its thing. Let's try and boost over here. That's where I want to go. I need to recolor the Cyclops too. Alright. charging these power cells. Whoa! Boost! You're almost there! There we go.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay. Can I access its power cells directly from here? No, I have to eject it. Becomes part of that. Alright, okay. We're looking good, though. We're looking good. I need to make some... Did I have titanium to make? No, aerogel was what I wanted to make, wasn't it? That's right. I probably do need to make some titanium as well. Let's pull out one more of these and I can make another aerogel. Yup. I can make a copper wire from over here. Make two copper wires. There we go. Two copper wires. We need three titanium. Right there. How much titanium do we have? So I need six in total. I think I've got two in here. I've got two. So I need one more set of four. How's these reactors doing? Doing alright, to be honest. You still need more water. Alright, that's charging its cells, so we'll leave that alone for a minute. And go see if we can't find some more stuff. There's gotta be some stuff around somewhere, right? Everybody loves stuff. Some quartz there. Pick that up, might be able to make some more here. We might be able to make another reactor rod if we get enough titanium. Have all four reactor rods going. There's some metal salvage, that's always good. Any more metal salvage kicking around? Metal salvage. Some quartz. There's some metal salvage. Nope, that's salt. I actually don't want that. Get that out of my inventory. I've got loads of salt that I don't even use. Like, I've got excessive amounts of salt and I don't even use it. Come on. There's gotta be some around here somewhere. There it is. Ah! Give me that back! Gimme! Bastard. There's more metal salvage. We're gonna need some for the forward base, so I might as well gather a bunch while I'm here. You know how it is. If there's any more, like, eggs and stuff. Let's get this.
New creature discovered.
Ooh, fish. See, I can actually take these fish here, these different kinds of fish, and I can put them in my aquarium. So I'm gonna do just that. Head back in that direction, grabbing fish where I can. That's outcropping. Here's another one, speedfish. I put these in my aquarium. Unfortunately, I can't get those biters. Oh, there's a peeper. I want one of those! Oh, my inventory's full. Never mind, I don't get a peeper. Alright. How's the charging going, game? How are we doing charge-wise? We, energy fully charged, excellent. Alright, so let's hop down. Do that. Pull out a cell. Swap it for a dead one. Boost myself back up. Let that charge. Oh, there we go. Alright. I mean, I can only charge them one at a time, but, you know, it seems to be working. I can get all of them charged. Let's go make some more titanium. I'm thinking I'm not going to have time this episode to actually go and get the, the habitat. So we might have to do that next time. But what I can go and do is, what was I coming through here? Aquarium, that's right. Yeah, that's right. Smoke the bulkhead. Alright, now we can put all these fish in here. Two, three, four. There we go. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. There we go, we've got a little fish in our aquarium. Yeah. Awesome. Alright. We're looking good. Cosmetically, we're looking good. There's my little cuttlefish. I wonder if I get another cuttlefish egg. I've never seen a cuttlefish out in the wild. I found the egg, but it was in like a research station. Maybe there's like only one egg. But if there are cuttlefish like deeper down, maybe I can find some like some cuttlefish and like breed cuttlefish, and I can just like have adorable fish everywhere. Let's get this titanium. Excuse me. Alright, there we go. Make some more titanium out of it. Make some more titanium out of it. And then we'll make some glass. We need one lead and one uraninite. So let's get a lead out. Go get a uraninite out. That's empty. Uraninite. Yep. Nope, sorry, I need two uraninite. Two more, I need three in total. Let's get this. Let's produce some. Let's produce a reactor rod. Got it. Let's go stick it in here. We still haven't used a reactor rod yet. So there we go. I think it's now fully charged. Yeah, only depleted reactor rods. That thing's now fully charged, so that's good. Alright, good. We're doing good. And the solar panels are doing the rest of it. So, that's still filtering water. So, let's see if we can put another one of these in. Put one here. There we go. And, where's our coffee machine here? And then put one more in. Huh. It's gonna be a problem. I'm not gonna have space. I got enough titanium to make a locker though, so let me put. I mean, can I just deconstruct the storage container empty? Let me put another locker, a wall locker over here. And this will be like the salt deposit. No power. Oh crap. Let's get a fully charged power cell in here. Alright, let's get that. Let's swap this out for a new battery and charge the old one. Oh. Alright, there we go. Let's put another wall locker in here. One more. Come on, give me one more. There we go. I knew there was a reason I picked up extra titanium. Yup. Alright, it's gonna be salt. And salt. No, not salt. Salt. Not salter. Salt. There we go. Let's pull salt out of here. All the salt. There we go. Put it in here. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Salt. Yep. And fill this up with more salt. Yep. Leave that one in. Take the water out of this one. Deconstruct it. Change this to water. Put my water back in. Then construct another water filtration system right here. There we go. Now these should keep running for a while. There we go. Awesome, now we got loads of water manufacturing up. That's it's manufacturing water. That is two. That's two. We've got lots of salt here. I'm gonna go eat some Chinese potatoes. Sorry's fault. Okay, of course it is. And put one back and eat another one. These give me water as well, so I just like munch my way through like all of these. 3 water at a time. Nom, 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 nom. I need 3 left by the time I'm done. So, yep. And then 1, 2, 3. Yep, that's enough water for now. Alright, so things are looking good. We've got more water filtration done. We have our salt storage done. We got our nuclear reactor working finally. Our power cells are charging for the Cyclop. So it's all looking pretty great. So I think what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to leave it here for this episode. Next episode, we will 100% head to that Degassi habitat. And sea moths lying on the freaking ocean floor. And take a look into making that forward base. So, yeah, that sounds like a good plan. So remember to like and subscribe. Hit that bell for notifications on more videos from us here at CJ Games. We upload a new one every day. And I will see you guys in the next one.